I am not going to find someone. I'm waiting for someone to find me.
This is Big Brother. With Cleo coming to the diary room.
Oh, clenchy buttocks. I'm really nervous about this one because it's my fantasy. Hello, Big Brother.
Cleo, you asked, is Clint Eastwood the son of Stan Laurel?
Yes.
He was born at St. Mary's Hospital in San Francisco to Clint Eastwood Sr. and Margaret Ruth Runner. Stan Laurel is not the father of Clint Eastwood.
No. Oh, Big Brother. I'm devastated.
p.m. Most of the housemates are in the bedroom. Ian, Cleo, Shilpa and Jade are in the kitchen talking about today's lunch.
We cooked the chicken today for 2 hours. No, I'm just telling you how much time I cooked the chicken because we cooked it exactly for 2 hours, 15 minutes.
You carried the other day, I enjoyed it, and I said that to you. I said to you, I said I was sick after, I said, but that wasn't because of you, that was because of me. I said your curry was very nice. I said, you don't need to sort of go away and get upset about it. You don't need to do that. Everybody.
It wasn't that. It wasn't you. If you were in my place and if Joe said that about the chicken.
What did she say? But it weren't only Joe. I said it. Joe said it. But it was pink.
It's over. It's done. They speak to me. I speak to them. I'm fine.
Joe was the first to speak up when you were feeling at your lowest, when Carol walked out that door. Joe was the first to walk in from that toilet and say to Danielle and myself, I don't like bullies and I don't like people being felt as if they're, what was the word? Let me get the
isolated.
Word.
Isolated.
I've never
had any doubts about Danielle or Joe. I feel every day there's an altercation, there's a clash, there's maybe also because I come from a completely different country. So I can't be what y'all are. I can't be your friends. I'm just gonna go back, y'all guys will be together, so you know. I just feel completely.
I mean, you don't really fit in, really.
I don't fit in. Yeah. And I don't wanna spoil your scene, so I just try to stay away because I don't wanna be like a sore thumb.
I wouldn't want you to feel.
No, I don't feel anything, really. I just want this thing to get over with.
See, I'm not really that.
As long as I'm here, I'll try my best. And that's it.
I'll be honest with you, I do sometimes think to myself, I don't really know when you're genuine and when you're not. Now, this seems very genuine to me.
Yeah,
but I do look and I think, is she being fake? Is she being real? Is she really upset? Is she really happy? You know when people are quite hard to read? I find you hard to read. Like, I'm not having a dig at you saying, don't never cook again, do-do-do-do-do. I'm just saying that for your own benefit, I think you should take a step back.
Yeah, I was only going to do that.
But not in a nasty way, I'm just saying,
as in,
if anything, I'm being quite nice by saying that.
I'll take it, I'll make my own food, I'm okay with that. I mean, I shouldn't know why I was doing this. I must be really stupid.
Cleo, Jade and Shilpa have been talking in the kitchen for 36 minutes.
Today is the first time, I think in the last, 5-6 days that we've ever had a conversation.
You're hard to sort of think, yeah, she's genuinely upset. Like the Carol, I knew you were genuinely upset, that's why I come over and said, are you okay? And that's why when that all kicked off, I thought, what the hell?
That I didn't take up for Carol is that when you thought that I was not being genuine.
I think what shocked you people was when Carol and Cleo come up on the screen and, you know, I couldn't pee, I just couldn't do that. You know, I know Cleo and I just got to know Carol and I liked them both and I couldn't choose. You then piped up and said, you know, we've got to get it over with.
Yeah.
And then you choose. And also more to the point, not because of it was Carol and Cleo, but because you was also involved. Yes, you didn't say whatever they had said, but you was there, so I thought that you would have just gone, I'm not going to be part of this. Whereas I think Cleo would have gone, yeah, but you do. Because we did. We didn't do it.
It was part of their choice.
It's each of their own choice. That was your choice to have done that.
If we didn't, they would have still made
it. Exactly. But that would have been their choice, not yours.
It was still a hands. It was a hand down win, even if I did put.
Exactly. So you made no difference anyway, but why did you do it?
Because I was just pushed to it. Maybe I didn't think about it so much, Jade. I didn't make the rule. I didn't say choose between Cleo and Carol.
No, you didn't. But you did it. You choose to do it and I choose not to do it.
Yeah.
You choose to do it, Daniel chooses not to do it.
Which I think was fantastic. Maybe you could take that, you know, maybe you're willing to take that risk. I didn't.
All I'm saying is I think that disappointed a lot of people. And I think I know
that's
that disappointed
fine.
A lot of
that's
people
fine.
Because
fine.
We were shocked with
I
your
really
reaction.
Like Sharon.
I can't speak on it, but I've
been Cleo never made personal attacks. Cleo never was aggressive. She didn't make fun of my toes. So I have my reasons. And if I'm fake.
No. That's when I then thought, oh my god,
but
I don't know if she's playing a game, she's fake, she's genuine. I've seen her all over Carol, I've seen her saying, you're this, you're great, I love you, do do do. You know, within a matter of 10 seconds, you're out shooting up there. I just thought that maybe you would sat on your hands and thought, I am not choosing between these two people because I sit there every other night and tell them both that I love them. So I refuse to be part of this. I don't need to be part of this. So I refuse to be part of it. But you wanted to be part of it and you chose to be part of
this
it.
Is a
and
game.
That was a shock.
And that was...
Exactly.
That was
this is the game. You're playing the game. You're right. You just hit the nail on the head. It is a game and you're playing the game. You're right.
I'm playing the game by the rules. I'm not playing any mind games here. I'm just playing the game by the rules of the game. I'm not playing any mind games.
But, you know, everyone in here is a really nice person. We just need to...
Yeah, I don't. It's been years of being in the business. I've never had a single person say that I was not genuine. That for me is a shock.
I'm sorry, please.
I'd rather you say that to somebody else.
You know what?
Never be fake because that's the known thing about Shilpa Shetty.
You see, that's how I am.
That's me. And you know, I laugh, people make fun of me. They say, Dirk, and they say, oh, and they laugh, and I'm scared to even laugh anymore because I feel you're just going to poke fun at me.
It's got to be difficult for you to come from all this. And
I don't know how
you are. Yes, of course.
What?
Yeah,
Shilpa.
The thing is, you know, you're both really honest people and it needed to be able to speak to one another.
Yeah, you need to know that I'm not going to lie. I've never lied to you.
Yeah, but you needed to be able to speak to each other like tonight.
You know, Shilpa, if 2 seconds before I was slagging you off. Nah, I wouldn't.
Don't be upset, and I'm sorry that you're upset.
You don't need to be sorry, you don't say anything.
No way.
I'm leaving Cleo. I'm gonna go to bed.
Tomorrow's another day. We should start. We should go to bed.
Good night.
Good night, Jude.
It's a show. Shilpa is a show.
The shy and retiring John McCrurick.